Hey folks, this is IO Ether, and we're back with some more World of Tanks. As you can see, this is Strife in his AMX M449. This is a tier 10 game, so we're bottom tier on Mountain Pass, and this is a tier 8 French premium heavy tank. So, because of the fact that this is a premium tank, it is basically nothing like any of the other French heavies in the original line. And so if you're familiar with the original line of French heavies, this is nothing like them. It's a lot more like the line they just added for the French heavies, where it's got a lot of frontal armor. It's got a lot of armor in general. And so basically, you don't want to shoot it in the rounded part of the turret, and you don't want to be shooting it in the angled frontal armor, especially if he's angled at something like this kind of degrees, which he should be if he's, you know, trying to balance shots. Also, you don't want to be shooting it in the side because, well, you're probably not going to pen that either if he's at the right angle. You're just going to be bouncing off both of these. Now, there's three spots you can shoot this thing where you're going to pen no matter what, assuming he's angled like this. And that you can fire right through this beautiful cheek plate right here. That'll go right through and do some sizable damage. You can fire through this turret ring, assuming you're close enough to hit it. And you can fire through that cupola. Of those three, I would take the cheek plate because it's the most obvious and the biggest target, and it doesn't move quite as much as the turret ring might move around on you, depending on if he's jolting backwards and forwards. And the turret and the cupola definitely will move as he's wiggling the turret back and forth, which he should be doing if he wants to avoid people shooting it. So this is a bottom tier game, so in order to win this thing, we're gonna have to really make sure every shot counts, and we take shots against the right opponents at the right time without missing too many. So there's a T69 as the first opponent in our list. That's good. The I7 and the M103 and the 268 we can see on this side of the map. So that's going to help us out quite a bit. Now the grill is the only thing that could be a problem, but it's most likely up here aiming down towards that IS3. So if that's the case, then we should have okay with pushing up here. The only problem I can foresee is that T-32 is American, as is the T-69. Those things are both going to be incredibly hard to dig out, assuming they're smart enough to get themselves hauled down, which they probably are, since we would have seen them already if they are charging. Oh, no, the T-32 is pushing out exactly the wrong time. T69 bounces that. Where'd that bounce off of? That was straight off the front. And then tracks. And then does actual damage with two shots, but leaves himself open. And we get a shot in. Now, our Yagzilla just pushes right past and dominates that poor T32. I don't know what he was thinking. But in charging, he leaves himself perfectly open for Strife to put a shot through his lower glacis and finish that little tank off. And there is the grill. So that is the three biggest tanks on their team, nowhere near us. However, we are losing the south badly. So we really need to finish this push and then start hitting them from behind. His team is pinging him, or that's him pinging himself. I don't know what that was about. I didn't actually read the chat. But you can see him actually, by aiming in, he's keeping that T69 at bay. 69 really wants to run, but there's no way he can do that without dying. He's going to get shot by the Yagzilla, and Strife is in a great position to follow up and finish him off. Because it's unlikely, unless the Yagzilla really high rolls, that he's going to finish him off in one shot. Scorpion G is following us. Not pretty close. He's actually looking like he might be trying to see if there's anybody going to go across there. Yagzilla gets his tracks blown off and then blows off. I assume it missed or blew off the 69's tracks in return. And then the Yagzilla actually blocks the shots from 69 so that Strife can fix his tracks. I don't think that was... You know what? I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt and assume that he was intentionally trying to help Strife out and not just jumping in his way so that he could get the next shot and we couldn't. But he's got marks on his barrel, so we're going to assume he's a good player and give him the benefit of the doubt. Yeah, and Strife gives him the thank you as well. The Grill has fallen back with the Scorpion G, and the combined damage takes out our Scorpion G fairly quickly. Now, when our Yagzilla gets here, he should be re-goaded, and he should be able to put a nice shell. Now, if he's loaded an HE shell, that will be great. However, I doubt he's got HE goaded, since we didn't know that they were here before we pushed around this corner. On the upside, our team seems to have won the south somehow. And now there are only this two guys trailing, dealing with a mini mouse in the middle, and us trying to deal with the Grill and the Scorpion G here. Scorpion G went to be a good bit aggressive and then bounced the shell. So it's probably I don't think he's gonna get overly aggressive. It's the Grill really that is up in the air. If the Grill decides to get overly aggressive, our Yagzilla could have some problems, but most likely I think these two are actually firing either on the IS-3 or on the T-54-T-28 combo down here. I don't think they're aiming at us right now. The Scorpion just dunked a shot nearby us, so maybe he was aiming for us. But the Grill doesn't seem to be looking in our direction at all. It seems like he's looking more for escape than attack. And the Scorpion G just backs off the cliff. Strife is going to cut him off to make sure he can't run. At least not this way anyway, and doesn't manage to flip himself, which is good. Coming up behind a 13-9, put a nice shot into, that should be damaging his ammo right there, back, nice shot into the back of his turret. Should damage his ammo, should be able to, apparently this guy's AFK, so I should hope Strife is going to use him as cover. Skype is not the name of this tanker. I'm so sorry, Strife. Actually, Strife just ignores the 1390 and goes for the great shot on the Scorpion G. He could actually ram the 1390, there we go, and carry him with him and use him for cover, which I would totally do. The additional is you get that bonus damage in on him while you're doing it. The problem is it might wake him up. Now, the Yagzilla just took out the Scorpion G, so we're not going to get that shot in. And the Grill is all the way down here. He's looking like he's going to get taken out by a pincer move from the 268 and the 54. I don't really think that the Grill is going to go for a base cap, but he really could be. Yagzilla, though, looks like he's going to try and steal our kill. Got to go for the ram kill. I don't think it's going to be in time, though. It is! Yeah! Ram kill for the win! And the Grill looks like he is tangling up with our T-54 right now. I'm going to blow the map up so we can actually see what's going on and speed this camera up a little bit. Grill is actually hiding right now. I'm thinking he's trying to bait the T-54 over the ridge line in such a way that he can kill the T-54. I don't know what where Strife said it exactly. But the T-54 and the 268 crash, but we kill the Grill. Sure. We'll count that as a win. I'm fairly certain the Grill's counting that as a win, too. Maastricht Badge, second class, Bruiser, Fire for Effect, Kamikaze, and a ton of cash. Well done, sir. Top on experience. Top on experience in a Tier 10 game isn't all that hard for a Tier 8 tank, but it is a lot harder to get, third on damage. The two top players managed to get themselves killed, meaning we are the highest living guy on damage done. Well done, sir. And with only firing 11 shots and every single shot they hit went in. Wait, what shot missed? The one against the Scorpion coming up the hill. Yes, of course. That was a risky shot to take anyway, and worthwhile, but unfortunately it missed the target. Does net him a ton of experience and some nice bit of cash. Well done, well earned, and didn't cost him a whole lot at all. Good job, sir. Thank you so much for saying this in, Strife. If you guys think Strife deserves the MVP, then please do hit that like button. If you think I deserve more subscribers, then please share this, and all things thank the Patreons, for they are awesome. And I'll see you guys next time. This is IO Ether out.